Our coverage starts with Who's Sports Center? Who's Sports Center at 7 Eastern? Oh, that's Stephen A's pregame Sports Center.
Who that?
At 7 Eastern. And it is now time for another installment of one of our favorite games, Something, Nothing, or Everything, with a very special guest. Welcome back to the job, Stephen A. Smith.
I appreciate being with my peeps.
We are
I appreciate
so
being
happy.
Miss y'all. It's good to see
so
good to
happy
y'all.
When you're in the building.
Absolutely.
We even made new Something, Nothing, or Everything boards in honor of your arrival here.
Okay.
Shouts again to Katie Bodmer. Thank you for
Thanks,
making
Katie.
That look good as always. And first up, you know it's the we could not talk about any other team.
You see him?
You being here.
You see him?
The New York Knicks. 9 straight. Beat the Raptors 120-103 on Saturday. The longest winning streak for the Knicks since the 2013 season, which coincidentally not was the last time they made the playoffs. So Stephen A, is the Knicks 9-game winning streak something, nothing, or everything?
Well, first of all, it's everything. All right, it's everything. When you haven't won the title since 1993, when you haven't been relevant since 1973.
Oh,
I apologize, 1973. Okay. And on top of it all, you haven't been relevant for the last damn near quarter century. Of course, it's a big deal. But I also would like to add this, the number one defense in the NBA. They play together. They are building a culture. And by the way, I'm saying it right in front of RJ and right in front of you, Ray Trent, right in front of you, 7-time champion. Let me tell y'all something. The more the New York Knicks elevate in their level of relevancy, the more pressure it puts on the Brooklyn Nets to win the chip, because the Knicks getting to the second round of the playoffs is a better story than Brooklyn going to the finals and losing.
Oh.
You heard it here first.
Oh. Do you think that's true, Robert?
Yeah, he does.
You know what, Stephen A., I will agree with you on that. But I'm also going to say this everything. And it's everything because my boy Julius Randle is getting MVP chance up in MSG. That's what I'm talking about. Julius Randle is taking his game to another level. You know, when you look around this league and you talk about players that have improved, to me, this guy has stepped up tremendously. He gets my vote, if I had a vote. The most improved player.
Yes,
if you
sure.
look what B.I. did last year, who got it, he's doing exactly what Brandon Ingram did. So if he doesn't get it, it'll be a travesty.
This is
Richard.
This is just
resident news.
This is tragic.
Give it up.
This is tragic.
Give it up.
Look, I'm going because they don't want to hear positive things from me.
Give
but
it.
I'm going to still say positive things. I am so glad that they have done the things, and I truly believe it starts with Dolan, then it went to the front office, and then they brought in a coach that was going to run things. It wasn't going to take any mess from people up top.
Mm-hmm.
He was going to hold his ground. He was going to bring in the type of players that he wanted. And then you get a guy like Julius Randle that just has one of the, like, he's all NBA this year. He's an all NBA player, in my opinion. I said this a couple of weeks ago when they won 5 or 6 games, and it looks like they were going to be the playoffs. This is before they went on a 9-game winning streak. Mm-hmm. So I think, look, all the credit deserves a Knicks.
Right.
Now, you get the credit, and you deserve it, but the job's not done.
The job's
keep
not
pushing.
Done.
Keep pushing.
Keep pushing. But by the way, do you realize that Julius Randle's 3-year-old son is a better story than most people in the NBA right now? Just watch
he's
the
son. He's hilarious.
Because he's hilarious. He's hilarious.
He's
crying, talking about he hates the Nets. Another week, he's smiling and blowing kisses. I mean, Julius Randle's son this dude is a headline,
was the last
okay?
time the Knicks lost?
All right, and by the way, I do have a vote. He is the most improved player. I want to say that, number one. And number two, he is a legitimate MVP candidate because they have come out of nowhere. The New York Knicks. The New York Knicks.
I want to ask you about the culture that you were just talking about, building the culture. So my thing for the last, 10 years, however long it's been, is you don't get a participation trophy in the NBA. We don't just pat you on the head and say good things about you when you are being. And look, you've said it. There have been times this franchise buffoonery, that they have been engaging in. The change that you have seen since Leon Rose, World Wide West, Tom Thibodeau came in, and the players buying in, do you feel that the franchise has really made a turn for real?
I believe they have. First of all, James Dolan is not stealing headlines for idiotic reasons.
Yes.
So that goes a long way. Number two, Leon Rose is showing he knows what he's doing, a la Rob Pelinka, even though he got that job not having much of a relationship with James Dolan, while obviously Rob Pelinka had a great relationship with Kobe Bryant as his former agent. Number three, you look at World Wide West. We all know how connected he is. And we know, William Wesley, and we know Scott Perry has been a reputable executive for some time, long overdue getting recognition. But Tom Thibodeau, being the fixture that he is, being a guy that mandates a level of discipline and structure and is about team play, you can't say enough. I'm willing to go so far as this. I think the culture with the New York Knicks at this moment in time is better than the culture at the Brooklyn Nets. I'm not talking about Sean Marks because he's done a sensational job. Mm-hmm. I'm just talking about in terms of, you know, players, guys being injured, guys being out, guys taking personal leave, stuff like that. The New York Knicks is a bunch of no-names that just showed up, grabbed their lunch pail, went to work, and they're winning basketball games. Right now, the culture with the New York Knicks at the moment is better than the culture for the Brooklyn Nets. The Brooklyn Nets just have superior talent, far superior talent.
Fighting words, though, which I would not expect anything less from you, friend. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.